But we're going to put into practice the measurements that we've taken. The full length of the dress was 29, and I'm going to be adding like a bodice to the top of this. Now you can decide on exactly what length of bodice you want to add to this. Where'd you get that from?
Over there.
Oh, that's somebody's sari blouse. That's a sari blouse. Okay, so what we're going to do is the full length of this particular piece is 24 inches. Now, I can do a variation depending on the length that I require. First of all, what I will do is I will take away, I've pressed this, and I'm going to try and keep this as simple as possible. So I'm going to take away the slight bit of unevenness at the bottom, and this is going to be the bottom side of the dress. So take away so that it's neatened off from the bottom side. Then I'm going to decide on the length that I want to keep this garment. This particular one, the full length that I require is the full length that I require is 29 inches, and so what I've got to decide is, so if that's 29, I can decide on how big a bodice I'm going to add to this. The waist length was 9 inches, so I can either have the bodice going on top of, if I want it like more of a flary type, then I can have that further up. If I want it more fitted, then I will have the bodice a little bit lower. Now I'm going to take away just the top part of this, because I want to keep as much of this pattern as possible in this. Okay, I'm going to notch it here. And I'm also, this has been pressed, I'm also going to notch it here. So the length that I've kept this is, be careful, the length that I've kept this is 22 inches. No, you can't cut that, okay? You can cut that red one, but you can't cut the velvet, because I need that. Look, you can cut that red one.
Why?
Why is not a thing that you ask, okay? If I say, then that's it, I say. So that's the bottom part. So out of this, what we've got left is just this. Now we can actually use this in front of the sleeves or something if we wanted, but it's not really, I don't think there's really any purpose to it. What we're going to do is we're going to use this to do our bodice. I'm going to cut the bodice one at a time. So first of all, I'm going to cut the front. Now, to make the length, the required length, what we're going to do is we're going to make the bodice length 8 inches. I'm just going to mark that across. Now the waist measurement was 20 inches and half of 20 is 10. And half of 10 is 5. So this is just a little bit more than what we require. But we want it just a little bit more, because we don't want to make it too tight. And then the shoulder measurement is 9 inches. So we want this 5.5. Now with children's armhole cutting, it's not very deep because they're not heavily chested or anything. And then we're just going to do a little round neck. And later on, what we'll do is we'll just pipe it.
I think my dad's going to add the...
I don't think so, not yet. Your dad was going to have a bath first.
My sister's so happy today because he's got made into his clothes.
So that basically is the front bodice. Now the back one, we're going to do that a little bit wider. And out of this piece, we also want the sleeves. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out the length of the sleeves, because that will give me...
Let me look at this dress.
Now, if the sleeves are coming out short, then what we can do is we can add this little piece to the front of the sleeves to make them longer. So what we've got to bear in mind is we want enough fabric left over to make the back two bodice pieces. Okay, so we needed a 13 inch full length sleeve. I'm going to take I'm going to add that to the front of it.
So we don't like a badge.
Put them back. And then I'm going to shape the sleeve a little bit. And the depth of the armhole will not be too deep. So we'll come back to that one. We'll finish the sleeve off first. We'll take some parts of this to add to the front of the sleeve. Now the other thing to bear in mind when you add something, if you've got, obviously we're working with pieces, so we're sort of limited on the amount of fabric that we've got. So what we're going to do is, just to make these sleeves longer, we're going to add an additional piece underneath, and we're sort of going to make this into a cuff and attach it to the front. So that's the sleeve parts done. Then out of this, we're going to create... Okay, we've got this. This is the main piece that we've got left to create two of these back panels. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to use this, our template, but we're going to leave a slight bit of excess here so that it gives us, and also the back neckline, we're not going to cut as deep. Then we're going to take this and we're going to put this vice versa, and we're going to cut the second piece from that particular area. Now you can actually do it this way and it gives you more of the room. Go and put it back. So by turning this around, it's given us that bit of extra fabric to actually put what we require without having to add any pieces. So that's the two. Now this is excess of the front one, because what we've done is we've tried to incorporate the piece that's going to act as our additional, either for the buttons or for the zip, whatever we're going to add. And then this is the front. The front is a little bit smaller than the back. What are you doing? You put your head in where the zip goes. That's not where the neck goes. Oh, you are a comic. Okay, now this we can take out the piece for the neckline and anything else that we require. If we were going to do just a basic neck, then what we can do is, just to save ourselves the extra work, obviously we're trying to cut corners here and we're trying to do this like in the easiest way possible. So what we're going to do is we're going to just... You want to go home? Your daddy will collect you, don't worry. Your daddy will collect you, don't worry.
So, I want to go home, Daddy. It's so cold here.
Ah, she's all excited about going to Asda today, so she doesn't want to stay with Daddy. I cannot believe that.
Okay, come on, Daddy, take me.
I will. Your daddy will collect you. Don't worry. Okay, don't worry. Your daddy will collect you.
No, I want to go home now. Take me, you. You take me.
You have to wait.
I don't want to wait.
You don't want to wait?
No.
Oh, you have not got no patience, Inaya.
I don't got time yet.
You've got lots of time.
Huh?
Just phone your daddy and tell him to come and take you.
Where's your phone?
My phone is in my pocket. You can phone Nas Chacha.
Hmm?
You can just phone Nas Chacha.
Why?
And tell him. Chacha, can you just come and take me? Daddy's busy.
Please, daddy, you have to take me.
I have to take you. I don't have to do no such thing. Why do I have to take you?
Because
you said, oh, since when did you start giving orders, madam?
I'm not a madam.
Are you not a madam?
No.
Yes, you are.
I'm not.
What are you then?
A coolie.
A coolie? You don't want to stay with daddy today?
No.
Why?
Because I don't like you now.
You don't like me?
No.
Okay, then. I'm not making you any clothes.
I'm just joking.
I don't believe in those jokes.
I just are joking.
You
but
are joking.
But that small clothes up there.
Up there is some small clothes.
Yeah.
Whose clothes are them?
Mine.
Are they yours?
Yeah.
Shall we make them for you?
Yeah.
Well, they're actually quite nice, aren't they?
I nearly got pink one clothes.
You haven't got no pink clothes?
No.
Yes, you have. You've got loads of clothes, even the pink ones.
Hmm?
Outfit number one, all done. So what we're going to do is we're going to quickly go and drop Inaya off, and then I'm going to come back and cut two further ones before we go on to actually stitching. So keep tuned, inshallah. I shall be back with more. That's just outfit number one. What we're going to have with this is, we're not going to have a pyjama or anything. She can wear leggings or perhaps we'll go on to make some white leggings.
I need a sword with it.
You need a sword? Well, it's not your dress.
Hmm?
I'm not making you a dress.
This is for
Leila.
Huh?
This is for Leila.
All right.
Yeah, I'm making them for Leila. Are you jealous?
No.
No? Are you happy that I'm making them for Leila? Good girl.
I am just sure.
What?
You're making for Leila.
Are you happy that I'm making them for Leila?
I think so.
Good girl. Good girl. Naya likes sharing. It's good to share, isn't it, Naya?
Yeah.
Okay.